In the lights of the 2020 events, today's video is focused on plague. And no any other plague but the greatest catastrophe known so far, which wiped out 60% of the European population. I hope you are all staying safe in these hard times. We will go through this together. Now let's get started. The disastrous mortal disease known as the Black Death spread across Europe in the years between 1346 and 1353. The name, however, only came several centuries after its visitation, and was probably a mistranslation of the Latin word atra, meaning both terrible and black. The Black Death was an epidemic of bubonic plague, a disease caused by the bacterium Yersinia pestis that circulates among wild rodents where they live in great numbers and density. Such an area is called a plague focus or a plague reservoir. The Black Death most likely originated in Central Asia or East Asia, from where it traveled along the Silk Road, reaching Crimea by 1347. From there, it was most likely carried by fleas living on the black rats that traveled on Genoese merchant ships, spreading throughout the Mediterranean basin and reaching Africa, Western Asia, and the rest of Europe via Constantinople, Sicily, and the Italian peninsula. Current evidence indicates that once it came on shore, the Black Death was in large part spread by human fleas, which cause pneumonic plague, and the person-to-person contact via aerosols which pneumonic plague enables, thus explaining the very fast inland spread of the epidemic, which was faster than would be expected if the primary vector was rat fleas causing bubonic plague. The 13th century Mongol conquest of China caused a decline in farming and trading. Economic recovery had been observed at the beginning of the 14th century. In the 1330s, many natural disasters and epidemics led to widespread famine, starting in year 1331, with the deadly plague pandemic arriving soon after. Other conditions, such as war, famine, weather, and poor hygiene contributed to the severity of the Black Death. The importance of hygiene was recognized only in the 19th century with the development of the germ theory of disease. Until then, streets were commonly filthy, with live animals of all sorts around and human parasites abounding, facilitating the spread of transmissible disease. The spread of disease was significantly more rampant in areas of poverty. Epidemics ravaged cities, and particularly children. Plague was easily spread by lice, unsanitary drinking water, armies, or by poor sanitation. One early medical advance as a result of the Black Death was the establishment of the idea of quarantine in the city-state of Ragusa, modern Dubrovnik, Croatia, in year 1377 after continuing outbreaks. Symptoms of the disease include fever of 38 to 41 degrees Celsius, which is 100 to 106 degrees Fahrenheit, headaches, painful aching joints, nausea, and vomiting, and a general feeling of malaise. Left untreated, of those that contract the bubonic plague, 80% die within 8 days. There are no exact figures for the death toll. The rate varied widely by locality. In urban centers, the greater the population before the outbreak, the longer the duration of the period of abnormal mortality. It killed some 75 to 200 million people in Eurasia. The mortality rate of the Black Death in the 14th century was far greater than the worst 20th century outbreaks of Y. Pestis plague, which occurred in India and killed as much as 3% of the population of certain cities. According to medieval historian Philip de Leter, it is likely that over 4 years, 45 to 50% of the European population died of plague. What do you think? What made the Black Death so deadly? Do you think if back then people had more knowledge they could have avoided this rate of mortality? Thank you for watching. If you are interested in more themes from the past, make sure to subscribe to Fun Facts History channel. See you next time with another informative video.